Today, I have a very fun question for you guys. Is it possible for us to find a function in the form of ax plus b so that the function plus its inverse is equal to x? Well, I will tell you, it's not possible in the real world, but it's possible in the complex world. You have to use complex numbers. But anyways, let's see how we can solve it. Firstly, we know this is our function. We can just plug that in right here, ax plus b. Well, how do we find the inverse? This is a fast way to do it for the inverse function. Check this out. Originally, when you start with x, you have to multiply that with a, and after that, you will have to add b. Now, we are going to reverse the order and also reverse the operation. Still start with x. Earlier, we added the b. Now, we have to subtract the b. Then, earlier, we multiply with the a. Here, we will have to divide it by a. Of course, once we divide it by a, we are saying that a is not equal to 0. Keep that in mind. So, let's go ahead and put that down right here. And make that equal x. So, we'll just solve it. Now, notice that this is doable because we have x to the first power. X to the first power, that's just a constant. And this is x to the first power. If you want to make this x squared, not possible. Anyways, let me multiply everybody by a so that we don't have to deal with this a. So a times this, we get a squared and x, and a times this, which is plus ab. A times this quantity, the a cancel, so it's just plus x minus b. Lastly, ax. Now, on the right hand side, we have ax. On the right hand side, we have a polynomial. We have to figure out the terms with x and then the term with all the x. This and that, they both have x. So focus on them, factor out the x. We get a squared plus 1, and then we'll put the x down here. These are just the constant terms. So plus ab minus b, that's equal to ax. Well, because we see that this is the coefficient of x on the left-hand side, that has to be the coefficient of x on the right-hand side as well. So we have a condition. The condition is that a squared plus 1 has to be equal to a. We do have a second condition, which is this right here. Second condition, I'll put it down here. AB minus B, this is the constant term on the left-hand side, but do we see any constant on the right-hand side? It's just 0, huh? So this right here has to be equal to 0. This is slightly easier to solve this first. Factoring out the B, A minus 1, it's equal to 0. Well, be careful with this. It's either B equals 0, right, or a equals 1. But I will tell you, a equals 1 is not going to make this work because we get 1 squared plus 1, which is 2. It's equal to 1. That's not going to work. So this is not a consideration. B is equal to 0, then that's out, that's out. So we don't have this part. So that's good. So this is what we need. We still need a though. Well, just solve that equation. Move this to the other side. We have a squared minus a plus 1 equals 0. Let's just use the quadratic formula. I'll just put it down here. A is equal to negative negative 1, right? And then plus or minus square root of negative 1 squared minus 4 times a times c. So 4 times 1 and 1. All over 2 times a. Solve this a little bit. We'll work this out, right? Just 1 plus or minus. This is 1 minus 4, which is negative 3. Aha! We get a negative number instead of the square root. So congratulations, we have the imaginary I. Yeah. So 1 plus or minus I square root of 3 over 2. So these are the possible answers for a. Well, two of them. And we have to have this with b equals 0. So finally, let me just write down the answer for you guys. Ladies and gentlemen, f of x equals 1 plus I square root of 3 over 2x plus 0 or 1 minus I square root of 3 over 2x. Pretty cool, huh?